Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is System and today we're gonna do the Q&A that I announced a little while back. It's the Q&A for the fact that we hit 800 subscribers, which is really cool. This is going to be the second Q&A that I've ever done. So it's gonna be interesting. We have some pretty nice questions right here. So I announced this Q&A about a month ago, I think, and we've already went from 800 to 835, which is pretty cool. So I guess let's get right into the nice questions right here. So the first one comes from Zerola, and you have a very interesting question. Roblecraft was active for 2 months. Roblecraft is my old channel, the one prior to this one. Roblecraft was active for 2 months. You have been active for over 3 years. I've not been constantly active for 3 years, but you know, I guess I have been active. How come that you have don't have more subs on your main channel, this one, rather than your old? This is actually very interesting. The thing is, I remember doing my 400 subscriber special on the old channel, which is the second to last video that I uploaded on that channel. After that, now that channel is at 1,276 subscribers. So basically all from 400 to 1,200 all happened after I went inactive. Now I'm gonna guess that this could have to do something with that, because this channel, my old channel, was all about Roblox and Minecraft. And Roblox is specifically, well, both Roblox and Minecraft have grown very much on the last years, I think that's part of the reason as to why. I think maybe as soon as I stopped uploading to that channel, a little while after, those two games just started to grow and grow and grow, I think that might be why. Now you might say that Minecraft and Roblox, if you make videos on that, it's very hard to grow because so many people are playing it. But this was a Swedish channel, so not as many people did it. And I think that's also part of why it grew so much. So I think it definitely does have reason as to why it happened. But this is the channel that I'm on right now, is the one that I'm truly proud of. Not to say I'm not proud of that one, but I'm definitely proud of what I'm doing right now. And I'm not really too interested in doing Minecraft and Roblox anymore, so this is where I'm happy at. I mean, I'm trying to grow this channel now, and it's gonna be better in the future, I'm sure. Next question comes from Robin Valentina. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing all of this right, but you know, this is not so much a question. Well, I guess there's a question behind it. You should get a G920 with a shifter. It will cost about $340, and lots of good drifters have it in Assetto Corsa. When I was going to buy my T150, my other choice was actually the G29. I was really, really, really unsure whether I was going to get the T150 or the G29. Now, the thing with the G29 is that you get a lot of value for the money. Obviously, the shifter isn't the best of quality, the feel of the wheel is probably not quite as good as the T150, but I've actually tried the G29 and it's actually much, much, much quieter than the T150, which I didn't really know. Now, maybe the feel of the T150 is better. I haven't tried them side by side, so I couldn't really tell. But I think for now, I'm not really looking to invest in a new wheel. I'm gonna use the T150 for Dirt 4 and the future as well. Maybe I will invest a little bit later, but for now I'm gonna stick with the T150. Maybe I'll give it back to the store, the T150, see if I can just pay a little bit more and get the G29. We'll see about that, but that's probably not gonna be in the near future. I think the other thing is that the G29, compared to the G27, it's just a very minor upgrade, so that's kind of what put me off about it as well. But I think overall it's just very good value for the money, even if the quality isn't up with Thrustmaster, but then you do pay a lot more for Thrustmaster. And I think the other reason why I wanted the T150 is just because it had the option to have the good shifter if I wanted it in the future, because the T150, the Thrustmaster TH8A shifter just seems really, really nice. But I do realize that if I'm gonna buy the pedals and that, it's gonna add up. But maybe some nice and juicy sponsorships could fix that. Yeah, they're probably not interested in me. But I think we're gonna move on. Thank you for the questions so far. Next question is from BennyDog1. Can I have a chicken nugget with barbecue sauce? Well, no. But the actual question is, where are you from and where do you currently live? Love your videos and you encouraged me to get a Thrustmaster T150. Keep up the good work and never give up. That's a very nice comment. It's, I actually had a few comments telling me that they bought a T150 because of me, which is really cool, and hope you enjoy the wheel. It is a good wheel for the money. It definitely is. So where am I from? I'm from Sweden. And where do you currently live? In Sweden. I'm not gonna get too specific, but you know, I live in Sweden and I'm born here. So I guess that's that. I know some of you probably are like, why do you care about sharing your spot? I don't know, if to me it just kind of feels weird to do that. It's not that I'm not one willing, it's not that I'm not trusting people in my comment section, it just feels weird. But I don't blame you, because there's a lot of other people that do share where they live, so I don't blame you at all. But yes, thank you for the question. Let's move on to the next question. Racing Maniac R2. Do you have any plans of getting a car? If so, what car? JDM Euro American? I actually do not know what I'm gonna get for my first car. It's gonna probably going to have to wait for quite a while, because first off, need a license. Now, I have definitely been thinking about this a lot. I mean, my first car, that's gonna be really exciting, and a really exciting day to pick up my first car. Been thinking maybe like something like Volvo, because they are really good value for the money. The only thing with them is pretty much every individual in this country drives one. Yeah, in Sweden everybody drives Volvos, like you see them everywhere. So that's the only thing. I mean, I do really like them, it's just that everybody drives them, and it just feels a little bit bland. And if you've been watching Theo, you've probably heard that he's also been talking about this, you know, why he bought the RCF instead of an M3, or it's also why he got like the IS200 for his first car. And I was also thinking, like, the IS200 would be a pretty cool car as a first one, because it's not rare, but it's definitely not something you see all the time. In here in Sweden, you see Volvos, Audis, BMWs, and freaking Mercedes. But at the same time, I don't want to get just the exact same car that he did, just because he did it. But the thing is, I was looking at other cars, like what other cars are there that aren't too common? And I mean, the IS200 is actually a pretty good choice if you think that way. It's a pretty good looking car for what it is. But at the same time, it's going to be a first car, and I should probably not be too picky, because, I mean, there's only so much you can do when you have a low budget. I mean, I'm not gonna get a car until I have a job, because, I mean, how the freak am I gonna be able to maintain a car without a job? I think that's gonna answer your question. It's gonna be very exciting when I do get around to really thinking about what I can get. But yeah, thanks for the question. We're gonna move on to the Killers PT, and he asks, "What's up? I'm currently answering your question, sir. What are your plans for the future and about the wheel and the setup?" So I'm guessing you mean what I'm planning to do with my setup in the future and my wheel setup. Or actually, I guess you mean plans for the future. I guess you mean YouTube. So for the future, obviously my goal is to be able to do YouTube as my job, and I don't care. As long as I can maintain a living and just have YouTube as my job, that would be really, really, really freaking cool. So if I get the opportunity to do that, then that is going to be a plan. But for now, I'm just gonna get through freaking life. So about the setup, I don't really have any huge plans for my setup right now. I guess getting a freaking new mouse, but for $10 when I got my computer, and it has a broken scroll wheel. So it's not, I guess that's something I'm planning to replace. Oh crap. And also, I would like to replace this Shiba. You know, it is nice to have a mouse pad with cat food branding on it, but I think I want something different. It would be nice to have something that matches the rest of the setup a little bit more. But other than that, I think I'm pretty happy with how it is right now. Maybe I want to do some cable management underneath this desk. Doesn't look too good. Cable management is kind of difficult, but I do want to try and make it look really, really clean. I had it really clean for a while, but things happened. And for the wheel, in the future, I do want to get a T300 or something like that with a shifter and the pedals, clutch and all that. But that's probably going to be in the future. And obviously, a wheel stand would be really, really nice, because it would make it so much easier when you're gonna actually play with the wheel. Because right now it's not really as convenient whenever I want to use the wheel. So I guess that's a thing. But yes, thank you for your question. The next question comes from Arvid Kornemal, which is actually a good friend of mine. And he asks, can you make a room tour video? This is something I've been thinking about for a pretty good while. I've actually been holding on to doing this because I really wanted to feel like my setup was not crap. Because at the time when I started thinking about doing a setup like this, I had a really crappy HP keyboard, and I had the Dell monitor that was square. I mean, I'm not trying to bash on somebody that has gear like this. It's just, if I wanted to make a setup video, you need to kind of stand out a little bit. So I wanted to feel like I had completed my setup a little bit and made it look a little bit special, at least. I mean, how many triple monitor setups have you not seen on the internet? So I mean, I don't really have anything unique, really. So, but I think it's something that I want to do in the future. Maybe I'll do it this year. Though if I'm going to do that, I really need to cable manage my desk, because that needs to be top notch. And I need to remember that I can do multiple setup tours. I can make them annually, which other people do. So that could be cool. So I'm definitely going to do that, hopefully this year sometime. So yes, tack för frågan. Let's move on to the next question, which is from Kasper Ljunggren. Is that a Swedish name? Ljunggren. I'm gonna assume that's how you pronounce that. Either way, you could tell me in the comment section if you'd like. But he asks, what editing program do you use? I use Adobe Premiere Pro, which I really, really like. I've used it for about 2 years now, I think. I could recommend it to anyone. I mean, I remember when I was gonna choose a good editing program, you know, moving on from freaking Movie Maker, I was looking at Sony Vay. Oh, my recording just freaking stopped, so that's also brilliant. But I was looking at Sony Vegas and Adobe Premiere Pro, and I was trying it. Sony Vegas first, and I wasn't really a fan of it. I don't remember exactly what I didn't like about it, but I remember as soon as I tried Premiere Pro, it just felt a little bit like home immediately. I really liked it. I guess that could be because I was already used to the interface of Photoshop. So I think that could have a little bit of a play in there. But yes, Adobe Premiere Pro, I could recommend it if you're trying to get into video editing and moving on from a more simple editing program. So yes, thanks for your question. Okay, so this name, Ivan Jovanovski. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce that, but I hope I didn't butcher too much. How did I do? Tell me, please. But yes, why do you have zero time to play Assetto Corsa? Well, I think I've talked about this before, but basically, Assetto Corsa, I think it's the wheel. Every time I use the wheel on it, it feels like I'm gonna break the wheel. It always makes weird noises when playing Assetto Corsa, and it's not because of Assetto Corsa itself, but it's because when you're drifting, you put a lot of pressure on your wheel, and at least my T150 starts to make a lot of weird noises when I put a lot of pressure on it. I don't know why that is. Maybe because it just feels like I'm gonna break it when I use it on the Assetto Corsa. Maybe that's just me, but I probably should try and get into Assetto Corsa more. But yeah, I never really get that problem when I play Dirt. But I should try and play more Assetto Corsa. It's also that it just takes more effort to make an Assetto Corsa video. It's just the setup process. I've talked about this before. I can link the video that I made about this below, but yeah, I talked about that in the video, so you can watch that if you'd like. But I do want to make more videos on the game. It is a really good game, and it deserves to get more attention. Thanks for your question. Next question is from Hiri. Is there going to be a Swedish video? I mean, you can watch Swedish videos on my old channel, but on this channel, I don't know. That would be very weird. Really weird, actually. But I guess it could be fun. I mean, but I guess that could be fun to do once. I'll consider it. Thanks for your question. Next question comes from Sprax TV. Do you want an intro for free by me? I'm giving intros to everyone for free. Thank you for offering an intro, but I'm not really looking for an intro right now. If I'm gonna make an intro, I want it to be pretty specific. And I want it to be my way. If I'm gonna have an intro, I'm probably gonna make it myself. Just because that's how I like doing things. I like being everything being by myself. And I mean, it's also why I've been holding off on having an intro, because I don't really know what kind of an intro what I want it to be like. But yeah, thank you anyways. Next question is from Dr. Salian Gaming. How do you afford your stuff? I think I'm gonna put it like this. I am very, very conservative with my money. Like, I don't buy many things per month at all. Like, I don't spend a lot of money. Like, I'll tell you that. My income is like $100 per month, which I get for going to school. After the 10 years of going to school in Sweden, when you graduate a little higher in school, I don't know what it's called in English, but the last 3 years that you should go to school, you get $100 per month. And that's really all I get. I don't really have a job. I did go have a summer job once, and I got like $500 from it. It was really, really crap. But other than that, I mean, I'm just really, really conservative with my money. I tend to just save and save and save and save, and then I just spend it on something that I want. And that's something I can really advise. Just be conservative. And if you're thinking about the monitors that I bought, they cost like $450. The three monitors cost that much. And that's because I chose these monitors very specifically because they were of this price range. If I was gonna buy something more expensive that cost like $300 each, then that would be expensive. But this, the monitors cost $150 each, and I had been saving up for it. So, you know, just be conservative. Thank you for your question. Let's move on to Joletska. Is that how you say it? Remind me in the comments to tell me if I'm right or wrong. But do you play Dirt 3 with PC or console? Well, I play it on PC. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to play it on three monitors. I play pretty much everything on PC, unless it's like Guitar Hero or like Gran Turismo 6 or something like that. But otherwise, all new games I play on PC. It's only games that aren't on PC that I would play on console. Other than that, I play on PC because I need those PC Master Race superior advantages. I'm kidding. But yes, that was all of the questions. I want to thank a lot for the questions that you left. I hope I answered your questions well. If there's any questions that I could have answered differently, then make sure to tell me. I mean, I think I answered them pretty well. But if you have something to criticize, then make sure to let me know, and I'll gladly consider your suggestion. But yes, once again, thank you for subscribing to my channel. We're not far away now from 1,000, which is going to be a really cool achievement, and after that we're gonna be able to defeat my old channel. I think we're gonna be able to hit 1,000 pretty soon. I mean, it should be able to happen this year. We've already hit 835, I think, so that was pretty fast. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have, then you can leave a like to show that you liked it, and you can subscribe to see more of my videos. But thank you for watching my videos, and thank you for subscribing, and I'll see you in my next video.